morning to all of you. At the outset, I profusely congratulate Dr. G. Vijayakumar and his team for making this platform. So the management option, of course, at the end, Dr. Dharmaraj pointed out, insulin is the best. Of course, we are gaining experience with metformin. And diet and exercise, oral hypoglycemic agents are still controversial. Human insulin is the standard of care. Insulin analog is emerging evidences. Analog designed closest to mimic the normal physiology. So as our professor pointed out, during pregnancy, Dr. Hariharan, so all the placental hormones are keep on raising. To compensate that, the woman should secrete natural insulin, but unfortunately this natural insulin is not getting secreted in some of the women due to various reasons, which he has highlighted already. So this compensation is not happening during pregnancy. So I will skip these two slides because he talked about pathophysiology. So glucose is still getting maintained normalcy, but whereas the insulin requirement is keep on raising once the pregnancy is getting advanced. To meet out that, no other go, we have to treat them with insulin. The ADA endos. So insulin is the preferred medication for treating hyperglycemia and gestational diabetes mellitus, as it does not cross the placenta to measurable extent. Of course, 30 years before, we had used plain and lenti insulin, which antigen antibody complex crossed the placenta. It caused macrosomia despite correcting the metal hyperglycemia. But we are now using human insulin. Recently, we are switching over to human analog also. As again, Dr. Balaji pointed out in February 2018 guideline, also our Indian guideline, from our Dr. Sheshaya and Anil Kapoor and Hema Devagar, they are all members in the guideline. So there also we recommend insulin is the first line of treatment. Of course, metformin as second line. Although insulin is recommended, human insulin have many limitations. Slowly absorbed, suboptimal postprandial glycemic control, inconvenient injection timing, 30 minutes before food, which is difficult for all of us, increased hypoglycemic risk, injection and meal must be planned. So limitations continuing, profile not physiological, postprandial control may not be good, increased risk of hypoglycemia, because postprandial hyperglycemia is the predominant when compared to fasting hyperglycemia, as you have seen in the pathophysiology lecture. On drawbacks, as we all know, this hexamer should get divided into monomer before absorption, so it takes minimum 30 minutes. So the ideal insulin is, should mimic physiology, improve glycemic control, no hypoglycemia, should not cross placenta, should not be immunogenic, no fetal or maternal adverse effect. These are all the factors we require to treat the patient with GDM. So which insulin is ideal for GDM? Regular human insulin, we are using it for more than 20 years. Biphasic human insulin or premix insulin, NPH, insulin aspart, insulin lispro, and insulin detimer as long-acting insulin. Recently introduced insulin fast-acting aspart. So your human actrapid is short-acting. Aspart is rapid-acting. This is ultra-rapid-acting. Fast-acting aspart is new insulin recently got introduced. And insulin glulagine, insulin glargine, insulin degludec, we need more studies, more experience. So insulin therapy for management of hyperglycemia and pregnancy, insulin regular and NPH category B by FDA, insulin detimer, safe long-acting insulin, aspart, again, safe rapid-acting insulin, lispro, safe rapid-acting insulin analog, whereas insulin glulagine and glargine oral, we require more data. Insulin analog definition, insulin analog are modified human insulin or designer insulins, molecules which differ by one or few amino acids from the primary structure of insulin, developed to provide more physiological replacement after subcutaneous insulin, synthesized by means of decompound DNA technology, provide more optimal time action profile. So insulin analogs, so these are all A chain, B chain, some changes converting into rapid acting insulin. So again, in the second slide, some changes making the normal insulin molecule to act long acting insulin. So this is faster aspart. Insulin aspart is newly introduced. So by adding niacinamide and L-arginine, absorption modifier, much more faster acting when compared to aspart. So approach physiological insulin profile, regular insulin, fast-acting insulin, ultra-fast-acting insulin. This is normal pancreas first phase of insulin secretion, almost mimicking the ultra fast acting insulin is mimicking the normal insulin level. So treatment of GDM improves perinatal outcome. Treatment of GDM reduces the risk of perinatal morbidity. So when compared to intervention, routine care is the more of macrosomia, more of shoulder dystocia, and more of perinatal complications. And insulin aspart is effective in treating the woman with the GDM. When compared to human insulin, the blood sugar reduction is much better with aspart when compared to human insulin. Adverse events also, malformation, severe hypoglycemia, fetal loss, preterm delivery, when compared to human insulin, in insulin aspart, very much lesser. And another study, rapid acting insulin analog, subjects on insulin lispro, subjects on regular insulin. If you read the safety profile, anti-insulin antibody were similar in both the group. Insulin lispro, fewer hypoglycemic events, no fetal abnormalities in the ethnic group, no difference in the both the groups. Similarly, in the other study also, no hypoglycemic events reported. Otherwise, human insulin as well as analog are both are same action-wise, but the convenient wise is analog is much better. Again, our own study by Dr. Balaji and Shashaya group, premix insulin aspart. So this first RCT of using premix insulin aspart in GDM in our country. The conclusion of the study is the pregnant woman found biphasic insulin aspart convenient as this preparation allows flexibility in the mealtime. Just before food or even after food they can have, did not disturb the routine life. Most importantly, biphasic insulin aspart was found to be safe during pregnancy. This is the first study to use biphasic aspart in GDM. Further studies have been required. So the recent study, April this month study, insulin analog used in pregnancy among women with pre-gestational diabetes mellitus and risk of congenital anomaly, a retrospective population-based cohort study. Results of the study, 870 fetuses were exposed to human insulin only, 397 fetuses exposed to insulin analog only, 394 fetuses exposed to human insulin and analog. The risk of major congenital anomaly in fetus exposed to insulin analog only was lower than those of the exposed to human insulin. The relative risk adjusted to glycemic control and region was 0.5. The significantly lower risk related to exposure to insulin analog was observed in congenital cardiac environment is much lower in the analog group. Conclusion of this study is in this retrospective population-based cohort study in the Europe, first trimester exposure to insulin analog did not increase the risk of major congenital anomaly compared to human insulin. A possible lower risk of congenital heart defect among fetuses exposed to insulin analog only deserves further investigation. The recent data have emphasized the role of glucose stability in the pathogenesis of fetal malformation as a single day of poor glycemic control had potential for a negative impact on organogenesis. Otherwise, first trimester glucose metabolism or glucose control is very much important. Again, this is the recent information. It is possible that insulin analog reduced the risk of congenital anomaly by achieving better glucose stability and consequently reduced the glucose level variation. Patients treated with the insulin analog had less frequent, very high glucose spikes or hypoglycemic episodes that might be responsible for impaired fetal development in the very early pregnancy. So we heard about the basal insulin analog. So again, when compared to insulin detimer, NPH, there is no much of difference except convenience. Levimer is considered to be the basal insulin analog of choice. And diabetes in pregnancy, safe insulin. Insulin options shown to be safe during pregnancy, as we have discussed, aspart, lispro, regular insulin, NPH, and detimer. If patient is unaffordable, you can go for regular insulin, NPH. Patient is affordable, requires convenient, you can go for aspart, lispro, or detimer, or biphasic insulin. So insulin pump therapy, safe and reliable method for satisfying the basal insulin needs in the pregnant woman, may be needed to combine with our continuous glucose monitoring, can be used to effectively mimic the physiology of insulin secretion. No significant difference in the glycemic control for pregnancy outcome with the continuous subcutaneous insulin infusion versus multiple dose insulin, can help address daytime or nocturnal hypoglycemia or a prominent dawn phenomena. Insulin aspart and lispro are the standard of care for continuous subcutaneous insulin injection, but disadvantages, complexity, requires counseling and training, cost, potential for insulin pump failure. So we are not using insulin pump therapy during pregnancy because of these drawbacks. So overall summary, the incidence of GDM is on rise. Overweight and obese women have been increased risk of developing GDM. Universal testing for all pregnant women must be there. If diet advice is not controlling, proper medical management before, during, and after pregnancy are key to prevent the vicious cycle of contributors to the obesity, insulin resistance, and type 2 diabetes. Focus on fetus for the future. So our expert opinion, GDM and pre-GDM, GDM fetal macrosomia is etiologically is thought to be multifactorial. Postprandial hyperglycemia is certainly its main and most frequent, which was highlighted by our professor. Particularly indication for short-acting insulin analogs are important to diminish the timing of postprandial hyperglycemia. So rapid-acting analog do not interfere with embryogenesis. These analogs belongs to category of B by FDA. So the conclusion, rapid insulin analog attractive for use in pregnancy, able to reduce postprandial hyperglycemia. HbA1c values, the number of severe hypoglycemia episodes were lower among patients using insulin aspart and lispro. Large prospective randomized clinical trials of insulin analog in pregnancy are lacking. No excess risk of adverse fetal or maternal outcome from the use of rapid-acting insulin analog during pregnancy. Balanced with the higher ease of use, satisfaction, reduced risk of hypoglycemia, and likely improved postprandial and overall glucose control with insulin analog when compared to